sad, isn't it? I've been working with you 7 years. 7 years. Always liked you. Always looked after you. I never trusted you.
And that is the secret.
That's the secret?
Yep.
Yeah, she's right, Tess. Everybody knows that already.
Yeah, why don't you tell us another one?
Fine. Secret number two. Fake it.
That's definitely not a secret.
Kinda is.
All right.
So how does that relate to what we're doing now?
I'll tell you. See, most women apply secret number two to one thing, sex. The rest of the time, we're too real. Too real because it's in our nature to be real, which ultimately is a woman's downfall. But faking it keeps you living in man's land.
Whoa, who the fuck wants to live in man's land?
We're already living in it, guys.
All right, wait, let me ask you a question then. Would you be faking it if you compromise? Because you can't fake compromise.
You half can.
What the fuck does that mean?
Compromise is half faking. Because if you weren't compromising half, you would have it all. In which case, you wouldn't be faking, you'd be taking. For example, guys compromise when they leave the toilet seat down. They do it because they know they can't win. And I'm not faking it because I don't pretend not to mind when they do leave the toilet seat up. Because I do.
Slow it down. How was that a compromise on your end?
Yeah, and I thought that you said we should fake it.
It's a compromise because I'd fake other things to get my way. Or I'd take away the pussy.
What are you even talking about? I think you're confusing yourself.
No, I think it's just too complicated for you to understand.
No, it's not at all. I get what you're saying. I just don't agree with you. To me, compromising is not faking.
Fine. Then we'll just agree to disagree.
Or we could agree that I'm right because that's a compromise.
Tell you what, I'll fake it and we can agree on that.
Okay. But you're compromising to agree on faking it. I can explain it to you if it's too complicated.
I think she got you on that one, Tess. Sorry.
Nice. Hey. Kara.
What?
Quit staring at that guy.
I'm not staring.
Yeah, you are staring. Do you know what the word conspicuous means? Or do you want me to explain that to you as well?
Kara, stop staring.
I'm not conspicuous.
conspicuous. We're the only girls in here with all our teeth. We're very fucking conspicuous.
Okay, but what if that's our guy? I mean, didn't Mel...
Do you see an orange rig outside?
What do you guys think about Harry and Sally?
What about them?
Yeah, don't worry about them, Kara. They're harmless.
So what if we missed him? I mean, we spent, what, 20 minutes with Deputy Elmore? What if he came and left? So, Tess, what are we doing? Do you have a plan?
Mel did say 2:30.
All right. So I'm guessing she runs the place. And there's no way this shit goes down here without her getting a piece of the pie. If anyone knows anything, it's her.
Okay. Okay, great, I'll take her. Let's find out what she knows.
Mm-hmm. I'll take the door.
Guess I got the trucker.
All right, I'm not even gonna say it because y'all know what this is.
You be cool, Billy Bob.
Who drives the truck and where is it? I said, which one of you shit kickers knows where the fucking truck is?
For the last hour.
I've been taking your shower. What have you been doing?
I've been putting gas in the car so we can get the fuck out of here.
All right, dude, stop giving me shit.
Get yourself ready. Tessa's gonna be pissed.
Pretty. Look, you're not a...
No.
Well, I just saw you back there, and I thought maybe... Sorry. My name's David. Well, Dave. My friends call me Dave.
Now I know what to call out.
Look, do you need a ride somewhere?
Does it look like I need a ride?
I don't know. Do you?
You know what, actually, Dave? My cell phone ran out of batteries. Do you have one that I could borrow?
Yeah, sure.
Great.
Here.
Thank
Thank you. I forgot the number. Thanks anyway. Sam, very sweet of you. Maybe I'll see you around sometime. What was all that about?
Fucking jerk off thought he could pick me up. So I thought we could use some gas money. $45.
What
fucking jerk off tried to pick me up and fuck me for 45 fucking bucks. Wow. It's 40 more than I'd pay for your ass. Ha ha.
So, what's the deal?
Deal is, we're going to some shitty isolated diner.
Where?
Somewhere across the river.
Why would Mel send us over there? He's never sent us out of the parish before.
Because something big has come up. Apparently someone's running a shipment along Mel's route.
Who?
Don't know, but Mel doesn't like it. There's a driver who's picking up a preloaded rig down in the Gulf. He brings it up to 220 and delivers the bricks to another driver who's waiting with the cash.
Who's the driver?
That's where we come in. Mel wants us to get a hold of the shipment and find out who the pickup is. Which brings me to the best part of this whole operation. Neither man knows the other. They only know where the diner is. So driver A isn't going to do something stupid and risk getting caught with a load of dope. He'll just drive away. And same goes for B. I mean, the last thing he's going to do is go crying to the feds about his drug money getting ripped off. We just make sure we get there before they do and wait for one of them to show. Hey!
What? I was listening. Other side of the river. Fine.
It's fine. It's a big fucking deal, Kara, so you might want to pay attention. Mel wouldn't be too happy if we fuck this one up, too. Speaking of which, yeah,
south on the 140,
other side of the swamp. Look for an alligator crawling across the Chinaman's back.
2:30.
Well?
140 south, 40 miles.
Evening.
Evening.
Little car trouble?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, looks like your tires are a little low there.
Yeah. Sure is.
That's not good to be out here this time of night without any hair in your tires. Yeah. We got skaters out here the size of footballs. The heat don't get you, they sure as hell will. That's the recipe for problems right there. First thing, you're fixing your tire. Next thing you know, you're lying on the side of the road, died of heat exhaustion. What's your name, partner?
Endicott. Because I'm not in the car. I'm out of the pot. I'm in the cot. Get it? Which is where I wish I was right now, because I'm so tired and it's so hot out here.
It is hot, isn't it, yeah. Endicott? Well, Endicott, what seems to be the problem? You got a busted hose or something?
Something like that. I just can't seem to manage this engine.
Mm-hmm.
It's just. I don't know what to do because I gotta get to my girl, and she's just as sweet as a daisy. And this thing on the jig right here, I just don't know how to handle motors.
Well, you're in good hands tonight, Endicott. Why don't you step out of there for a second? Let me take a quick look at it.
Would you?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hold on this. I used to race big blocks down in Douglas Parish. I know a thing or two about engines. Probably just a busted hose or something.
Cuidado. Careful. Careful.
God damn, it's hot out here. In the last year this time, I hit about $110 over in Bronson.
Yep. Well, I see the problem right here.
You bought Japanese.
Guilty.
Next time, buy American. Yep.
It's my sister's car.
Uh-huh.
I just drive.
Yeah, well, you tell your sister, next time she should buy American.
Hey, Don.
Yeah.
this feel funny to you?
No. Why?
I don't know. Just that we're 40 miles from town?
I wouldn't worry about it, Kara.
What was the one good thing Mom used to say to us when we were kids?
Always make sure he wears a condom. Oh, no, wait, sorry, Kara. That was what she said right after your dad left town.
Oh, what? That's what she should have said to your dad when you met him.
Oh!
I'm serious.
Said she wanted us to trust in ourselves.
Okay. So I'm trusting in myself. I don't know, I know something doesn't feel right.
Yeah. You know what, I'm trusting in myself. And everything's telling me that it is right. And I know Tess is a little tough, but I need you to trust me. Can you do that? Well, you know what? That's all right, Kara, because you're probably just overthinking things like you always do.
Are you joking?
No.
I go along with every plan. What's wrong with you? What, I have an opinion? Is that the problem?
Yeah, Kara, maybe that's a problem. I wouldn't call it an opinion, but I think that might be the problem. I'm just saying, try enjoying it a little.
I am enjoying it. Okay. A lot, actually.
All right, well, when you really start, let me know. I'll pull out the video camera.
Yeah. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Where are you guys laughing at?
Me, apparently.
There you go.
Don doesn't think that I can enjoy anything.
Can you?
Really? You too?
I mean, really?
Why do you guys always have to team up against me? Oh. I'm the nicest person I know.
Oh, really?
You guys are full of shit. Uh-huh.
Oh. We just pick on you because you're new.
Fuck you. Look how big I am now.
So I'm guessing she runs the place there. And there's no way that shit goes down without her getting a piece of the pie. If anyone knows anything, it's her.
Okay, great. Great, I'll take her. Let's find out what she knows.
I'll take the door. Guess I got the trucker.
All right, I'm not even gonna say it because y'all know what this is.
You be cool, Billy Bob.
Who drives the truck and where is it? Which one of you shit kickers knows where the fucking truck is?
Save it for later, but since your radio sucks, I got us some tunes.
And lucky for you, some of us still live in the golden age.
Yeah, what age is the golden age?
Oh, the 80s, and not just the 80s, but Bruce Willis in the 80s.
No!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Get ready for Respect Yourself like you've never heard before. Hey, Kara, even you might enjoy this.
Hmm?
Oh, Bruce Willis?
Kara, you gotta get this.
No. No, I'm not supporting this.
Who even sells this shit? I don't believe it.
No, girls, it's not funny.
Come on, Kara, get some learning.
Wow, you guys think you're funny, don't you? Tess, take the shit out. Throw the shit out the window. This is my car. Take the shit out.
Guys.
Gone, why are we being pulled over?
Just chill.
What's going on?
Shit. Fuck. What does he want?
Did you steal the tape?
No, of course not.
I told you, Kara.
I told you.
Kara, did I not say it?
pull it together.
Just start listening. Just for now.
Just be cool. Just fucking be cool, Kara.
How you doing there, beautiful? It's hot, ain't it? I can see you sweating over there, but, you know, you just wear it so well. You're just as sweet as a little daisy, ain't you? So where y'all headed? Where y'all here this time of night?
Sorry?
I said, where y'all headed? Way out here this time of night.
Yeah, we're heading up to see some relatives. A sick relative. Out in Chaparral.
Chaparral? Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
A relative, you say? Mm-hmm. All right, then. On the count of three, I want y'all to say the name of the relative that you're going to visit at the same time. One. Two, three.
Uncle Mel.
I'm just fucking with y'all. Y'all didn't even have to answer that. No, seriously. Did it get you going? Because that shit never gets old. Can I get your license and registration, please?
Yeah. Actually, you know what? It's actually my brother's car, so I don't have the registration, but I think it could help a girl out.
That's all right. We don't really get to do this too much way out here anyway.
Can I ask why you pulled us over?
Oh, shit. I'm sorry. Your tire's low. I can't have you driving out here with no air in your tire. You don't want to be changing the tire out here in this heat. Miss Samantha.
Now you were saying, Greenman, last night, Charles, that true friends do not come from outer space, stars, but from the Greyman beneath the bedrock. The hollow planet, Charles, it's inside Earth. Well, you got your Area 51 in Nevada. Well, I know that you've probably not heard of Area 52. I think I have. That's in Hoboken, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Right underneath New Jersey.
Yeah.
I'm taking two. Randy? 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 Fuck. Fuck me.
Elmer, pick up. Hey, Elmer, pick up. Elmer, it's an emergency.
Pick up. We got a 1027 down at Randy's stop. Elmer, pick up. Randy's been shot. Fuck me.
Yeah, boy. Tell you, this heat out here, it'll kill you. And me, I just wouldn't want to have y'all dying out here and me having to call your mamas and give them the tragic news.
Yeah, no, we wouldn't want that either, officer. Thank you.
Cuidado. Cuidado. You got to be careful out here. Now, there's a truck stop just up the way. I think y'all need to pull in there and get yourself some air in these tires.
Yeah, great. Will do. Thanks, officer. Sounds good.
Fact. I can follow behind y'all. Make sure that you get there in one piece.
No, we're fine, officer. Thank you very much. We got it. Mm-hmm.
Come on now, come on. You gotta call me officer. You can call me Elmore.
Well, Elmore,
That's my name. Elmore. Mm-hmm. Elmore hugging. As in, you hug me, I hug you. It's a regular hug in. You get it? Elmore hug ins. Just cracked myself up. Huh?
It's funny.
Fact. You know what I'm gonna do? I can turn on them blue and reds, and I can escort y'all if you want to.
No. No. Really. Just falling behind us would be fine.
Yeah, you sure about that?
Yeah.
Could be fun, though. It could be fun.
Yeah, bet it could be a lot of fun. But, you know, we're really fine. But thank you so much.
All right. I'll be the boss. You ladies, may you be safe now.
Great. Thank you, officer.
What the fuck was that all about?
Don't ask me.
This is it? This is the big exchange point? Are you kidding? Plus, why are there cars here? I thought you said this place was empty.
Have I been here before?
Yeah, Carrot's probably the late night rush.
Tass, are you sure? What is with the 20 questions? Yes, I'm sure.
Hey, relax. Relax, I was just asking.
I am relaxed. I'm very fucking relaxed.
Dude, don't get mad at me, all right? This was my fucking idea. Genius.
What do you want from me, huh?
I don't know.
Right no, I think you do. Tell me, what do you want from me?
I want you to acknowledge that it's a little strange that Mel would even give us another job after how bad we fucked up the last one. Okay? And this is where he sends us? I mean, call me crazy. This doesn't feel weird to you? Don?
Why do you do that?
What? What am I doing?
That. Questioning. How long have we been doing this for? How long?
Are you serious?
Yeah, and how many times has Mel ever steered us wrong? How many, Kara?
None.
Right. None. So what are you so worried about? What? Look around, Kara. There's nobody, no witnesses. It's like the easiest job we'll ever do, all right? In fact, it's probably why Mel sent us here, so we can get our shit back together. Think about it.
Hey, is Mel fucking you yet?
Fuck you.
Fuck me?
Yeah, fuck you for saying
fuck
that.
You, Tess,
you
for bringing me all the way out here. I never fucking said it.
Chill, both of you. Chill. I don't even know what you guys are fighting about anymore. But every time, it's like fucking World War III. I don't care what it is. We have a job to do. So not one of us is leaving this car until we are all fucking calm. So there are these four nuns. They're sitting outside the confessional. First nun goes in. She says, "Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned." The father goes, "How have you sinned?" She says, "I'm so sorry, Father. I looked at a man's penis." Father says, "Oh, that's terrible. I want you to say 10 Hail Marys and go out and wash your eyes with holy water." So the nun says yes. She walks out, says her 10 Hail Marys, up to that basin, washes her eyes out with holy water. Second nun goes in, says, "I'm so sorry, Father. I have sinned. Forgive me." Father says, "How? How have you sinned?" She said, "I touched a man's penis." So the father goes, "Oh, that's even worse than the last one. I want you to go say 20 Hail Marys and wash your hands with holy water." So the nun steps out. She does her Hail Marys and washes her hands with holy water. Suddenly there's a commotion. The priest comes out, he's like, "Whoa, what's going on?" Because the two sisters, like three and four, are fighting. He's like, yo, sisters, what happened? What's going on? Fourth nun, who's been eavesdropping, steps out and says, "I don't care what you say, Father, I am not washing my mouth in that water after she sits in it."
Wow. Nice one, Don.
Don, you're retarded.
You really just told that joke.
I like that joke. My daddy taught me that joke.
It's even worse.
She runs the place. And there's no way this shit goes down here without her getting a piece of the pie. If anyone knows anything, it's her.
Okay, great. I'll take her. Let's find out what she knows.
I'll take the door. Guess I got the trucker.
All right, I'm not even gonna say it because y'all know what this is.
You be cool, Billy Bob.
Who drives the truck and where is it?
Which one of you shit kickers knows where the fucking truck is?
Drop the gun. Drop the fucking gun! Put the gun on the floor. I'm gonna put your fucking brains all over that fucking table. Do it! I'm not gonna ask you again! You got 3 seconds to put it down. I'm gonna put you down like fucking Thelma and Louise there. Three! Chop! Two! Listen, Jesse Jane. This ain't Jeopardy. You don't get a fucking option here. Your only option is to put down the fucking gun.
No. You put your gun down.
Fuck you. I'm not dropping shit.
All right. Obviously, none of us are going to drop our guns. So let's just talk about it.
Paul, you want to fucking talk? This ain't fucking couples therapy. The only one talking here is me. I'm telling you to drop the fucking gun.
Listen to me. We'll both just put our guns down at the same time.
Well, just shut her up. Jesus. See, I don't think you understand what's going on here. Fully, okay? If you had any sense left, and I'm betting big on your baby right now that you do, I think you put that down before Mel gets here and he fucking blows his book.
Mel?
Yeah, Mel, big guy, blue suit, always says fucking pecans. Oh, that's right. You don't know shit, do you? You know why? Because I'm in fucking control of the situation.
How the fuck do you know Mel?
Oh, me and Mel, we go way back, baby. That's right. A gravy train that you've been on, it's over. So you might as well give up now, because there's no way that you're walking out of here.
What about the fucking dope? What about the dope and the money?
Dope? What dope? No fucking dope. The fucking money. The only thing I know about money is our mutual buddy Mel pays pretty fucking good.
Mel wouldn't do that to me, Mel. Wouldn't do that to me. Oh, yeah? Mel wouldn't fucking do that to me, all right? You're lying.
Shut up! Shut her up! Mel wouldn't do that? I bet he told you that someone's infringing on his corridor. Is that right? That the story? That the one you got? Hmm? And he sent you here to fucking figure out who it is. Is that it? Is that getting close? Are you out of your fucking mind? You think someone's actually running their own shipment along Mel's route? You think he doesn't know what's going down here 24/7? That someone's got the balls to step up in his shit? And you think that there's something weird going on? You think he'd send you 3 fucking bimbos here to figure out who it was? I mean, even I'm not that stupid. And I never even got through high school.
You're slipping. You're getting sloppy, Billy.
What the fuck are you doing? What the fuck you doing wearing a cop uniform for?
The more prevalent question is, what the hell are you doing here? And why isn't everything taken care of?
What? The fuck you care? You're not in on this.
I care because it's a hot fucking night, and I've been roasted outside for over an hour, and all your dumbass managed to do was this.
Dumbass? Fuck you! Shit got out of hand. These 2 Midwest tours motherfuckers wouldn't leave. And this fucking cunt here and the 2 dead sisters decided to shoot up the joint. I didn't plan for this shit.
Well, aren't you lucky that I showed up then, huh?
Yeah. So quit standing there with your thumb up your ass and help me out of here. This bitch is violent.
Calm down. Just calm down. Now, will somebody walk me through what happened here,
they
please?
They shot us.
What?
They
what
shot
the fuck
at
are you
us
talking
and they
about?
Shot my friends.
They? You're the ones who decided to go off fucking boogie nights and fucking shoot up the joint, set off a nuclear fucking bomb in here. They fucking shot Francine, Ronnie. They fucking shot her.
Oh, that's sad.
Ronnie, tell this chick what the fuck's going on with Mel and everything. All right, help me out here.
I'll get to that.
Why is he calling you Ronnie? I thought you said your name was Elmore.
Why don't both of you just put your guns down before you 2 kids get hurt here, okay?
Fuck you. I'm gonna kill this fucking cunt.
Hey, you calm down. Ain't nobody getting killed right now.
I am calm. Don't tell me to be calm, Ronnie. I'm calm as a fucking kitten.
You sweating like a junkie over there. Now you just calm the fuck down. You hear me?
What the hell is going on?
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut your fucking mouth.
Billy?
Who are you? Who are you? Why aren't you doing something?
Me? Shit, Tess. You must have a lot of tears clouding those eyes. Come on. You don't remember me. Come on. Come on! Come on! I am the delivery guy. It's the first decent piece of ass I've seen in this place all night.
Tell me again, what the fuck are we doing here, man?
Just relax, B. It picks up, I'm telling you, man. Later on, this place will be crawling with pussy. Taste like piss, man.
Yeah? This place smells like piss. All right? Why aren't we at Cabaret Club or Foreplay, Zebras?
All right. Look around. Look at our competition.
What competition?
Exactly. Any other place? We just know. Here we get free fucking ring.
Free fucking ring? Of what? King of the ugly bitches? Sis, I wouldn't fuck any of these chicks with your dick. I feel like I'm getting herpes by just looking at these chicks. Now, I don't know what kind of chicks you're nailing, but I got a stack of hundreds burning a hole in my back pocket, and I would rather let my pants flambé my fucking cock off than to pay any of these trailer rats get anywhere near my dick. I'm serious, fucker.
You need to relax, man.
I'm not sitting in some putrid shithole just because you don't feel like you're up for a little competition, man. These bitches should be paying me to be in here.
Oh, boy. All
right, now finish this shit. Let's get out of here.
Anything else the boys want?
Wow.
All right. Thank you, God. This is what I'm talking about, right?
I told you this shit was legit, right?
Oof.
Baby, where'd you come from,
huh? Right over there, actually.
You got a sexy mouth on you. I love that shit. Look, what do you say you get off work early and we head out to my place? Yeah. Third floor, Fairfield.
You know, I'd love that, but I gotta work, honey.
I'll make it worth your while.
Oh, that's sweet. But unless you're gonna make it worth my while every day, I got a job to keep.
She's got a point, B. You know, make it worth a while, man. Fine, all right. Look, why don't you give me your number and we can get together after you're off.
I don't get off until 5. But hey, how about you give me your number and I'll call you? Sure.
Playing me like a bitch now, right?
Yeah.
Do I look like a dumbass to you?
No, you look like a good tipper. Tell you what, for one of those bills, I'll hook you up with Charlene over there. She'll take care of you. She'll finish you off before you can even say cock-a-doodle-doo.
All right, fuck Charlene, okay? I want you.
And I told you I don't get off until 5, so next time.
Hey, come on. I think there's a little misunderstanding here, all right? Come on, it's a simple question, right? How much is it gonna take?
Give him a number, he'll pay.
Oh, no, I understand. Not for sale.
Everything's for sale. It's just business, baby. Now, look. You're a smart girl, right? Just give me a number and it's yours.
Okay. You want a number? 4.
4. 400?
Inches. That's the size requirement for this ride, and you're 2 inches under the limit. Sorry.
Look, bitch. I don't know who you think you are, but this isn't a multiple choice question. Right now, there's a simple answer, and you're gonna give it to me. Hey, man, what the...
Hey, no, man, what the... Take it easy, man. It's only playing with...
You like questions? Because I have got a multiple choice question for you. That A, if they hear, pretend like you enjoy getting sodomized by church over there, you might like it. Or B, you can keep mouthing off and get the record for the quickest loss of your teeth, which I can make happen to you for no charge. No charge.
Oh.
See, you can pick up your jacket.
You and your boyfriend can calmly walk out, drive away, and never come into this club again. Now, cuidado. I want you to think carefully because I want you to make the right choice.
See, man. He's saying see. Come on, man. He's gonna break his arm.
Carajo. You want me to break his arm?
You want me to break his arm?
No.
I can break his arm if you want me to.
No.
You sure?
May your friend answer. Can your friend answer?
Yes.
Answer.
See.
Please. See as in yes?
See.
See as in yes, I let you go.
Please.
See. It's a good answer. I don't have to get bloody today. Adios.
Go. Vamos.
Hey, fuck you, man.
Wow. Thanks. I'm Jessica.
Of course you are.
Is that beautiful, man?
Yeah. It worked.
What?
You know what? Come on. Do you know what? Come on.
$20.
An old condom. A punch card for a lava latte.
Fucking maricón. Can't even drink espresso.
A Mexican card. Coño. It's a great haul. You really clean up on this one.
But are you a cop?
No coin.
Huh. That's too bad, isn't it? Girl really likes a man in uniform.
And I am sure that men in uniform, they like you too. You know you are much too special to be here. Mm. Huh?
Tell my boss that.
I don't need to talk to him. I have someone who wants to meet you. Come on.
Wow, nice house.
It is.
Yours?
I am just a delivery guy. The gate is open. You just know.
Okay.
Hey, don't forget me. And don't worry. I will never let anything happen to you. You will come out as fresh as a daisy. I am for you.
I am hurt, Des. I thought you told me you love a man in uniform.
That was 2 years ago. I saw you for 15 fucking minutes.
Yes, but I remember you. You were always special to me.
But hey, I won't hold it against you. Mel never did encourage Frank Schicks amongst his staff. Right, Billy?
Hey, baby, how you doing? Good to see you. You want a drink? Get in there and get me some goddamn burger.
Go on, kid, shut the fuck up! I don't even understand you.
Hey, baby, come on in.
She just fooling around a little bit. That's all. That's darling.
It's a good friend of mine.
Clean it up! Ah!
It's tits, but... Oh. Feel really, sit down anywhere. Feel free. No, it wouldn't sit right there. We had a little party here last night, and there was an accident in that chair. But sit anywhere else besides that. Really. You know, I like pecans. Love pecans, really. It's my favorite food. I don't think God has made a better food than pecans.
Thanks.
My God, I like them. I mean, that's just a... What do you think?
I don't know.
Allergies?
No.
Not allergies? Well, in that case, have some pecans. Just playing, but I'm not. But I kind of am. I do like pecans. They reduce your risk of gallstones. I should know. I had one. Hurt like a motherfucker right across here, the abdomen. I had it sonically treated, zapped it, no gallstone. Pete Rose had a gallstone. Weird, isn't it? You think Charlie Hustle had the same gallstone I have?
Who's that?
A baseball fan?
Not really, no. I wouldn't call myself a fan. My mom used to take me to some minor league games.
Your mom?
Yeah.
Was a baseball fan?
She did it for my brother, really.
Dad, not a baseball fan?
Not exactly.
I do find you interesting. An interesting girl, Tess. With one S.
Wow, impressive. You officially know everything about me.
Well. I don't know everything about you, and I'm not sure it's official. But yeah, I know some things.
And how's that?
I always try to find out as much information as I can about the people I'm planning on offering a job to.
Job? Mm-hmm. I already have a job. I work in a little shithole down on 3rd and Carlson. No, it's a place called Spiro's. I don't know if you know it.
Spiro's?
Strip club?
It is a shithole.
Yeah.
Strip club.
Dump.
Dump. Dump. I've been dumped for a long time. I know. I own it. The reason I pulled you out of that bullshit nightclub is because I thought that what I had to offer you would be interesting. Something that's better than going to the bar, going down there and talking to the local guys and letting them touch you and just getting groped every night.
You know what? You got the wrong girl.
$3 an hour.
I don't do that. I'm sorry.
Neither do I.
I serve drinks and I look cute. That's it.
You do both those things really well. You also do something else really well. You know what I'm talking about? Dude, I look like a cop. If I was a cop, I would have turned your dumb ass in by now. Shit. Ronnie would have done that by now. That was Ronnie out there, you know. Did he tell you his name? Yeah, probably not. Anyway, that's Ronnie. But I do empathize with your problem. Who doesn't want money? Who doesn't want it? Who doesn't need it? Who doesn't have bills to pay? I empathize to the nth degree. Because God knows it takes a special girl that knows how to do what you do.
Lifting wallets?
Yeah. That's a skill. I would say you got some balls, woman. You got some balls that clank when you walk down the street. No offense.
I'm taken.
I gotta get another drink.
I'll put a little bit more in there. Let me get you one too. Come on, I'll buy you a drink.
He is a businessman. And this is just business. But for me, this is the business of my heart.
Business of your heart? The business of your heart? You let us walk into this, remember? My friends are dead because of you, you fucking maniac!
What did you think was going to happen? You think you are going to work for a few years, collect your 401k, and retire to Boca Raton? You are a drug pusher, Des. You exchange drugs for a living.
Fuck Pete Rose. Fuck fucking baseball. I'm a football girl. I like Roger Staubach.
So don't sing me the goddamn national anthem like I give a fuck. You think I was lifting those wallets just to jerk myself off? See, I'm just a simple girl who appreciates a buck or two. But that's not why I lifted those wallets. I did it because I'm good at it. And fuck you for not noticing sooner. So do me the goddamn courtesy and stop talking to me like I'm your fucking date on prom night, all right? Like, I don't know what you do. Come on, let's not waste any more time. I'm willing and able because I can. I marked you. Pecan? I prefer walnuts. But I'll eat your fucking pecans all day long, Mel.
Congratulations. Come on. Walk outside. What do you know about coke?
Do you think you can bung $2 million worth of coke and just walk away? This last job, it was your last.
You never answered the question, Ronnie. What the fuck are you doing here?
I am glad you asked. Actually, Billy, I am going to need you to hand over the money. All of it.
What the fuck are you talking about? What are you doing, Ronnie?
Don't make this difficult, Billy. Now, there is an easy way, and there is a hard way. And I will let you choose.
Fuck you!
Fuck me? No, fuck you!
What the fuck, Ronnie? What the fuck are you doing?
I told you. You can either do this the easy way or the hard way. And apparently you are choosing the latter.
I didn't choose shit, Ronnie! Take your fucking gun off of me!
You have some dignity, Bill. You are screaming like a fucking schoolgirl. Now I am getting mine, and you are going to get it, and that is all there is to it. Because I ain't done, Bill. I ain't done.
What about the cop? You shot a fucking cop, Ronnie.
I didn't shoot the cop. You shot the cop.
Me? What the fuck are you talking about? I didn't shoot a cop. You're fucking delusional, Ronnie.
Do you think I expected you to just hand over the money?
What about Mel? What are you gonna tell Mel? That you shot me? Over the money he paid me to get rid of these fucking bitches?
You let me worry about Mel, okay?
What's he talking about, Ronnie?
What do you mean, what is he talking about? It's a setup. Open your fucking eyes. Can't you see the way he's acting? He was gonna wait for you three bitches to be dead, and then he was gonna waltz in here, and he was gonna shoot me for my money. Which, by the way, I don't fucking have.
You know you are half right. Half right. See, after you steal the money, you die valiantly in a shootout with the unlucky deputy outside. while trying to make your daring escape. Then I take one of these unlucky ladies, throw her in the trunk, take off, and bang, she disappears with the money and is never heard from again.
That's me and her, Ronnie. What about you? What the fuck are you gonna do?
I was never here.
Wait, I thought you said there wasn't any money. What money?
The money Mel paid him to get rid of you, Sri.
I told you it's not here. I don't have it. Ronnie, it's me, Billy. Won't you put your gun down? And let's kill this fucking chick. Let's get out of here together.
That is not going to happen. I was planning on leaving myself. But now that we are involved in this little pickle, I'm going to have to take Tess with me.
Her? Come on, Ronnie. I'll give you Jesse's half. I'll give you all of it.
I thought you said the money wasn't here. Where is he?
No, it isn't here. There's no cake here, Ronnie. I'll give it to you when I get it. You know Mel. Mel doesn't let anybody get no cash. You of all people should know that.
You are lying, Billy.
Lying? I'm the only one here that's on the level, Ronnie.
I don't think so. I saw you. I saw the money.
Oh, come on, Ronnie. That wasn't fucking money.
What was it then?
It was this. The tools! The guns!
Why is Mel doing this?
I don't know why you are so confused. You know the policy.
Policy? What policy?
Do you think that Mel gives two shits about you? He is not there for you like I am. I have always been there for you. But Mel, no strikes. You fuck up once, you are done. Isn't that right, Bill? He has always done this. He is paranoid. Do you remember that chick he told you about? The one that went on vacation? Cancun. And in case the pieces are a little foggy, this is why Billy is here. And this is how I fucked up. I wasn't there to protect you like every other job. I've been there for you every time. Every time. But just one time. This last time. If I had been there, we wouldn't be in this mess.
What are you talking about?
You're fucked, Ronnie. Your stupid fucking plan is flawed. This chick doesn't even know you.
Know me? What the fuck do you know about love? Tess, I know you see it. I saw it in your eyes in the club.
What? What did you see in my eyes?
You can't tell me that it wasn't there. I saw it. It was there.
There's nothing there. There's nothing.
You know you are getting there on my fucking nerves, Billy.
You think Mel's gonna stand for this? And you think in your wildest fucking delusions, this bitch is even interested in you?
Bitch, you're going to treat this woman with respect. If you call her a bitch, okay? I will shoot you dead. Now, Mel is the reason why I'm here. He is becoming careless. He's becoming senile. All he does is crack me guns all day. That's why I'm retiring. I came here to collect my pension. And now I'm going to collect my girl.
Your girl? I'm not your girl. I'm not your fucking girl. This mess is because of you. You understand? This is not because of Mel. Mel wouldn't do this.
I'm so glad you are such an expert on Mel. How many times have you talked to him over the last 3 months? Once? I work with the guy every day. I know Mel.
Yeah, I know Mel too, okay? I know Mel. This is all just a test. It's a test.
You think this is a big test? Does that look like a fucking joke to you? We're all fucked. Ronnie, will you please shoot this girl and let's get the fuck out of here?
I'm not going to ask you again, Billy, to calm down.
Fuck you, Ronnie.
You know what? Since you are being such a brave girl, and Billy here is a whiny little bitch, I'm going to make a deal with you. You don't have to tell me, yes or no. You just have to show me. I want you to shoot him, and then we will walk away together and disappear.
I'll listen to him.
But if you don't, I will have to shoot you both.
He's full of shit.
He'll shoot you before you ever get a shot off once I'm fucking dead. Look at what he's doing. He's double-crossing Mel, now he's double-crossing us.
You don't want to end up like your friend, Shear.
I'm telling you, he's a fucking liar.
He's gonna fuck you like he's fucked all of us. He's gonna shoot us, and he's gonna take the money.
Will you shut the fuck up, Billy, and let the girl think, for fuck's sake. Let her make her own decision.
How do I know you're telling the truth?
I came in freely of my own accord. Didn't I?
Liar.
I could have did you both quickly like I did them, but I didn't.
Thought I could walk in here and put a couple in this, but he's stuck. You're stuck, Ronnie.
Thanks. Marry me. I love you.
I'm telling you, he's on the fucking insane train.
You're going to have to shoot him now.
You're a fucking psychopath.
Make your decision.
Don't do it. He's insane.
Two. One.
Don't
shoot him.
Don't fucking
shoot him. You can't do it. Shoot him.
Don't.
So sad that you make this decision. We could have worked. I'm sorry, Tess.
No, wait, I'll do it. I'll kill him, I'll shoot him.
This is great. I knew that you,
don't.
You will make the right decision.
Fucking shoot me. Don't shoot me. There is no money. Ronnie, there's no fucking money. Don't shoot me.
You need me to do the countdown again.
Don't listen.
Three.
No, don't fucking shoot me.
Two.
Listen to me. Don't
one.
Fucking shoot.
coffee. Coffee's good for make you feel better.
I am done. Don't even know who the fuck I am anymore. I know who the hell the fuck I am.
I'm gonna tell you a little story, Ronnie. Parable. You know what a parable is, right? Like out of the Bible?
A long time ago, these cowboys and Indians were involved in a big fight. American Indians, pre-casino. Big fight. Arrows, bullets. You know how it goes. One of these cowboys, let's call him Bucky. Bucky gets himself captured by one of the Indians. Not just any Indian, the big Indian, big world famous fucking Indian, Chief Running Bear. So Bucky thinks he's fucked. Thinks his life is over, he's gonna be killed. The Running Bear, instead of killing him, he takes him back to the tribe. He forgets all about being a cowboy. Forgets all its cowboy ways. Old Bucky doesn't want for nothing. As you can imagine, him and Running Bear got very close. Very close. Running Bear makes Bucky his consigliere. Bucky makes heavy wampum. Heavy wampum. You know what happens next? He makes a mistake. He just started to get restless.
Yeah.
He didn't have enough.
No, no.
He starts forgetting everything that Running Bear had done for him. He looks at Running Bear and he goes, look at this motherfucker. Drinking too much fire water, smoking too much peace pipe. I can do it better than him. He just says, fuck it. Then he starts fucking Running Bear. And he fucks him. And not no Brokeback Mountain kind of fucking. You following me, Ronnie? The moment that he starts to fuck Running Bear, he loses something. Do you know what he lost?
He lost fucking respect for him. Respect.
Right.
Because he's looking at
lost respect. In that moment, the cowboy loses everything. He lost the thing that was most important to him. And for what?
For what, Ronnie?
So he could steal a couple more furs?
All I needed was to have something for myself. Well, something that would let me know who I was.
I've been working with you 7 years. 7 years. Always liked you. Always looked after you. I never trusted you.
Trust doesn't exist in this world, does it, Mo?
No, it does not. It does not. I know you've been stealing. Was this like some kind of goodbye present? All this?
A Running Bear, he had a heart once. He had mercy, he understood mercy once. Can he set the cowboy free in the desert, all alone?
How the fuck would Running Man do that? Set the cowboy free. Well, I don't think that's gonna happen. He sets a cowboy free. He knows that eventually, someday, that cowboy's gonna come back and start fucking him again.
What are we gonna do now, man?
You know what we do.
Maybe I fucked up. Maybe I made a mistake. Maybe I was desperate. Just trying to get something to feel, you know, anything, anything. But I ain't going back to where I was. Going back to the way I was.
Oh, I wouldn't do that to you, Ronnie. I wouldn't send you back. You know why? Because Running Bear has respect.
There's never any money, was it?
Not for you, cowboy.
Why don't you tell me a story? I like that, that cowboy story. I like that one. Only this time, could you let the cowboy, the cowgirl, ride off into the sunset together? Something good, something with a happy end.
All out of stories. Sorry, cowboy. Been nice knowing you.
Hey, baby. Tess, what's up?
Toss it.
I got Elmer. I am a fever. I ain't born typical.
typical.
So great. So
touchdown.